Hey fellow beauty finders, it's Mathias for Makeup, and I'm so excited you decided to click on my video today. So today I'm gonna do a really beautiful tutorial showcasing a fantastic collection of products that I recently wanted to try. And for those of you who are brand new to my YouTube channel, I am the only Hollywood professional working makeup artist who showcases women of all ages, all nationalities, and all skin tones in step-by-step tutorials. Comparing two different concealers. We're going to be comparing the e.l.f. 16 Hour Camo Concealer versus the Kat Von D Lock It Tattoo Cover Concealer. These concealers have a very big price difference. They also are supposed to perform completely different, but for many of you out there who are watching me who are on a budget, you've heard a lot of things about these two concealers on YouTube and on Instagram, so I wanted to break them down for you and give you my pro makeup artist review and tips and tricks on who I think this one or this one would be best for. So if you're interested in that video, stay tuned, it's coming right up. So now I'm going to be trying out the e.l.f. 16 Hour Camo Concealer. This is so overhyped. I've heard so many of my fellow YouTube beauty community creators talking about how this is a huge dupe for the Tarte Shape Tape Concealer. So I decided to try it out for myself. I got it in medium peach, and when it arrived in the mail, I was very surprised to see how actually light this was. How is this a medium peach? My face is a medium peach right now. I'm literally peach color. How is this medium peach? So the color selection, I don't know what to tell you. I can't guarantee your luck when you're buying online. I don't know if it's in store. I'm sure it is. You can find it and swatch them and test them out, but I'm gonna be trying this out for myself. I'm gonna pull this out. Now, the wand itself looks very much like the Tarte Shape Tape wand. So this is extremely, extremely similar. There's a lot of product sitting in this little tiny divot. Now, I see a lot of people going straight to their face. I don't like to do that. I'm a professional makeup artist who likes to keep my products sanitary so that if I do decide to bring them onto set or to a client's home or a celebrity for the red carpet, I don't want to cross-contaminate any of my products. So I'm going to be putting this concealer on my wrist palette right now. So two scoops, putting that back in, putting that down. So here's the color right here. Now I'm going to go ahead and take the sponge that I was already using to apply my foundation. This is the Juno & Company Microfiber Sponge. I did a review on this recently. OMG. If you missed it, check down below in the description. Now let me feel the consistency of this. This is, oh my God, this is so thick. Now, thick is not always bad. You just have to know how to work with thick. You have to know how to work, well, okay, let's not get off the train, ladies. Let's keep our minds in the beauty high road. So I'm gonna go ahead and tap the concealer under my eye. And because this foundation that I was reviewing actually was like about two or three shades too dark, I'm gonna go ahead and take the concealer and work that into my complexion so that it'll help lighten up the foundation. Now I'm gonna take the clean side of the microfiber sponge and I'm gonna go ahead and pat into that concealer. Okay, so first impressions of this concealer are a little bit goes a very long way. Look how much is still left on my wrist palette. Now, I did take two complete swabs of the doe foot applicator, so I did get a lot. I didn't expect this much coverage to come out. I actually really, really like it. God, this is so affordable, and it's such a good concealer. Okay, so I like that it dries to a semi-matte finish. I like that it's not super wet. Do you know what I mean? Like, it feels very creamy when you're first touching it. It feels like, ooh, this is really like goopy and not sticky, but very, very wet, hydrating. However, when it goes on the skin, it doesn't look wet. It looks like it's gonna stay exactly where I put it. Now, if you're one that's concerned with under eye wrinkles or under eye crepiness, this may not be the best concealer for you because I can tell that there's an ingredient in it that is almost evaporating and making it almost like self-set. So I probably don't have to put powder on this if I don't want to. So that might be good for some ladies, but at the same time, it doesn't look as hydrated any longer as this side, which just has foundation. What do you think? Leave a comment down below. I want you to be interactive. I want this to be a two-way street. Okay, next I'm going to be showing you the Kat Von D Locket Concealer in L15 Neutral. Now, I have never tried this before, but it is very, very, very overhyped. When it first came out, people were like swearing by this concealer. They were saying, oh my God, it just stays put. It goes exactly where you want it to go and it doesn't move. And I watched a couple of Kat Von D's, I think, tutorials about it when it first launched, and it definitely has a very strong staying power. So I'm not going to use quite as much. The doe foot applicator is quite small, which is probably a good thing. You don't want something that's going to have a big doe foot applicator if it is very, very, very concentrated. So it's obviously just meant to be, you know, spot corrected. Now, the color itself looks a little bit light for me, but that's okay because we're comparing it to this side, and this side is much lighter as well. So I'm going to go ahead and tap that underneath my eye and bring that down onto my complexion. And then using the flat side of the sponge, I'm going to tap that in just like I did the first side. Now, this one I didn't want to go too heavy because I had heard that it was really super full coverage, so I think I went less than I did on this side. So I'm going to add a little bit more. Same color. Okay, so this is a really interesting observation on my part. I actually thought, from what I had heard about the Locket Concealer and how I had heard that it is like a stay all day, like you can't move it, you can cover up a tattoo with it, I assumed that that meant that it was gonna be very dry. It was gonna like have a lot of alcohol in it, and it was gonna like lock to your face. However, I'm looking at this side of my face where I have the Kat Von D, and this side seems so much more moist and hydrated still in the eye area compared to this side, which has the e.l.f. 16 hour wear concealer. Do you see that? Do you see how much more hydrated it still looks around my eye in this area compared to this one? Now, the foundation that I had on first, of course, is going to change the consistency of the concealer because you're mixing something into the foundation itself. Now, the foundation was very hydrating, so it mixed really well with the Kat Von D. However, with the e.l.f. one is either so extremely mattifying that it doesn't care what's underneath it, because that's what it looks like. It looks like this one is just so hydrating and so, moist, dewy and fresh and glowy on this side. And this side looks, I mean, I like it, but I know that many of you out there might have an issue with it looking a little bit drier around the eye. Do you see the difference? Let me know in the comments down below. As always, I hope you enjoyed this video today. Please do be interactive with me and leave me a comment, even if it's just a hi or a hello, or I loved that A, B, or C product that you use in the midway point of this tutorial. I just would love to hear your feedback. Click thumbs up if you enjoyed this video, and remember to subscribe right down there by clicking on that little box if you haven't done so already, and make sure your little bell is clicked on for notifications of my brand new posts. And did you know that the way that YouTube's algorithms work, if you step away from one of your favorite creators for a few weeks, you will not be seeing their videos in your subscription feed. So the more active you are and the more videos of ours that you consume on a weekly or at least bi-weekly basis, the more we will show up. I can't tell you how many comments I've gotten from some of you loyal watchers that have been with me since 2014 or 2015 that will pop up out of nowhere and they'll say, oh my gosh, where have you been? How much time have you taken off? And I'll say, I didn't go anywhere. I do 2, sometimes 3 videos a week pretty consistently in between my celebrity red carpet clients and my days on film or TV shows. I consistently put out content, vlogs, behind the scenes, and reviews. So please do try to at least watch 1 or 2 of my videos every couple of weeks, even if not every single one sounds interesting. I would love to keep you here in my Beauty Finder Squad community. You can follow me on all social media at mathias4makeup, and you can use the hashtag Beauty Finder Squad if you want to be included in my special monthly giveaways.